Good morning. It's Saturday, the 22nd of November 2014. A warm welcome along to you today's United Kingdom Talk, boys and girls. I had a lovely, lovely evening last night, and I'd like to know something from you. Okay, I'd like to know something from you. So last night, my best friend, I had a rare Friday off. So my best mate wasn't doing anything either. So I said, do you fancy going out to dinner tonight? And he said, yes. So I said, I left it to him to sort of, you know, find somewhere to do it. If you see what I mean. I'm not very good at searching for things on Google and all that. I don't know why I type things. And it's the same with, like, you know, looking for cheap holidays and things like that. I can never find anything that I want. That I'm looking for, if you see what I mean. So I generally, even as far as looking for cinema stuff. You know when you go on, like, the Odeon, maybe you've got the Odeon app on your iPhone or something like that, or Showcase Cinemas, and then you start scrolling through it, and quite honestly, you know the words are so small in it, and then you've got the glasses on, and you can't see the bloody thing, and you're scrolling backwards and forwards. I can't find anything. And then, so we were doing this last night in the car on the way to this restaurant, right? We thought we might go and watch a film later. So he was driving, so I'm on the iPhone. I've bought the wrong glasses out because I've got driving glasses and reading glasses. Actually, I don't really need driving glasses. My long sight isn't too bad. So I bought the glasses out from the house on the way to this restaurant. And I've put them on, and of course the wrong glasses, you know. So I'm looking at this, and I couldn't work out in my head why it was even blurrier with the glasses on than it was without. So I had to take them off. It was dark in the car, and I just couldn't see what I was doing on this blooming phone. Always people say to me, oh, isn't your text big on that phone? Yes, because I can't see it properly, you idiots. That's why. And then I started finding, like, it was, what, which app was it? It was the Showcase app. Now, Showcase Cinemas. They're a group of cinemas we have in the UK. It was the Showcase app. And you get, like, a little line of very small posters for each film. I think there was Interstellar, which we saw last week. If you saw the little videos we do, I talked about that last week. There was Interstellar. There was a couple of, like, there was Ouija. We decided on Ouija in the end. But then you would click the thing, all these different films, and it kept coming up with there are no more times for this film today. And time after time that happened, I thought, are they showing any films at all? Anyway, eventually we decided on Ouija. Ouji or something like that. And it's all about these people that play Ouija board or something like that. So it was a supernatural thriller. I like the look of that. So that's what we were going to see. But it was blooming hard to find it. We didn't actually go and see in the end. And the reason is we had such a nice time at the restaurant. Now, he took us to, let me see, I wrote it down, a place called the Flowing Spring. By the way, it was the Flowing Spring. Ronnie, if you're watching this, not the Flowering Spring, the Flowing Spring, which was a really, really nice place. They do loads of vegetarian stuff for me in there. And it's in, oh gosh, I forgot where it is now. It's near Henley. It's on Henley Road, which is in Oxfordshire. Okay, Henley Road in Oxfordshire, the Flowing Spring. And it was a lovely place. It was, I expected a big restaurant. It's not the first one he tried. The first restaurant he tried, right, he rung up this place. I can't remember what it was called now. And he says, oh, good afternoon. I'm looking for a very good vegetarian restaurant. And this bloke said in a rather, you know, posh voice, oh, yes, sir, that's us. Can I help you? You know, something like that. Why do they talk like that? And he was saying, can you tell me what you do? Well, we do some tasters, sir. We do a five item taster, or an eight item taster and a 10 item. He said, okay, then we might like to book a restaurant. Well, we're very, very busy tonight, but we might be able to just about squeeze you in. And Ronnie says, when he says the bloke, could you tell us the prices? Yes, well, the five one starts at £106. Jesus Christ. For a meal? £106 for a vegetarian. They've only come out of the bloody ground, haven't they? Little bit of carrots and turnips and peas off a bush and things like that. £106 for a meal. Jeez. Each? I don't think so, dear. Especially not, as I said, I said to him, do you fancy going over? So I said to him, well, you choose it and I'll pay for it. Not £106, Ed, I wouldn't. Jesus Christ. £106 from, and his boyfriend would. He wouldn't think twice about it. He'd think, oh, no, it's not too bad. I don't know what their thing is, you know. They don't worry about spending money. You know, I mean, a pair of them, they're not exactly rich. Neither am I. You know, £106 for a meal. And apparently Ronnie then said, OK, well, I'll just check the times for him and I'll give you a call back. And he put the phone down, never to ring again, of course. And then he found this other place. And as I say, it was called the Flowing Spring. Really, really nice little place. I had a glass of red wine. Now, that may seem nothing to some of you out there who are probably on the bottle most of the time. You know, who's the drinkers out there, I wonder? Is it you? I bet you sit there with a couple of cans of lager next to you every single night of the week, don't you? Huh? Well, I rarely, rarely, rarely drink. Maybe a little glass of champagne on the plane or something like that. A glass of champagne on the plane. Pain plane. Well, that rhymes, doesn't it? I could be a poet. I could be a poet. And that's about it, really. So I had this glass of wine. Well, I mean, after about three slips, I was chatting away merrily, weren't I? Ha, 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 ha. It was a very old-fashioned pub. Excuse me. Let me just hit my cough button and have a good cough. Excuse me. Yes, it was quite a sort of real English old-fashioned pub. And you had to go upstairs to get to it. You might want to have a look it up, actually. The Flowing Spring. Let me see if I can find where what you're going to type in there. I should never find it. Flowing Spring, Henley. The Flowing Spring Henley. There it is. Look at that. Comes from, oh yes, the Flowing Spring Pub .co.uk. You'll find it. If you want to have a little look at that, there's a photo gallery as well. And you have to go up steps. It's kind of up high. And I didn't think, I sort of, you know, it's on a hill, so I presume that's why it's up high. But when I got home after the meal, I had a little look at this website, and it gets flooded. The car park and all around it gets flooded, which is why you have to go up steps to get to it. What a lovely little place. What a absolutely lovely little place. They didn't just do vegetarian meals. There were plenty of other, but it was a real homely welcome. There was only one bloke working upstairs. Who I assume is the governor, and there seemed to be a boy in the kitchen doing all the cooking and all that. And we had, apart from the glass of red wine, after I started chatting merrily, we had a mushroom and broccoli. Was it mushroom and? No, it wasn't. Mushroom and spinach pie with peas and mash. Oh, it was lovely. It was lovely. There was us, and the pub, because it's so small, it appeared to be quite busy. But I suppose, all in all, there were only other... there were three other diners in the dining area where we are. So it's three, four, five, that's five of us all together. And about, I would say, no more than about 14 people in the other part of the pub. Maybe up to 20. And it looked reasonably busy. And they have a quiz night there and things like that. We chatted to the governor. Really, really nice bloke, I suppose, about 48, 50 years old. What a nice man. And he had time to talk to us. Time to talk to us. Not like so many of the other managers that I've worked with over the years, you know, who haven't got time to talk to anyone. All they're interested in, they keep going over to the till, pushing buttons to see how much bloody money they've taken. That's all they're interested in now. They've forgotten the personal bit, you know. Years ago, the governor of a pub would be at the bar every night of the week getting drunk with everyone else. It's not like that now. They're so worried, you know, they're going to lose a penny, you know, because someone spilt a little, one of the bar staff has spilt a little bit of drink and that, and they come down and like, I could sit here and name names, I'd love to, you know. It's awful. But this bloke was really old school and he talked to us. So there's a highly recommended one there. And we had it was a lovely meal. And after it, oh, I'm very naughty, I had sticky toffee pudding with vanilla ice cream. And he had a raspberry pavlova thing, I think it was called. Very nice indeed. So highly, highly recommended that. Highly recommended. But I wanted to ask you today, on that same sort of subject, have you ever had a bad meal in a pub? You ever been so, or a restaurant, you know? And why was it bad? What was wrong with it? My worst meal was at a pub. I was actually working a pub club in Brighton. And I'm going back here probably about 12 years or so. And I'd ordered a fish and chips. That's right, fish and chips. Anyway, after a bit of a wait, and remember I worked there, you know, I thought, oh Christ, how much longer are they going to be with this fish and chips? It arrived. And the chips were okay. And I started eating this bit of fried cod. It was full of little bones. Oh, I can't be doing with bones. It was, I don't eat fish anymore, I'm vegetarian now, but at the time, it was full of bones. Awful. You know, and I thought, oh, it must be just an odd one there. And I brushed that aside, then I had another bit, and it was all the same. Bone after bone after bone. I can't be eating bones, dear. Oh, and it worries me. One of my friends, his name's Wayne, he's he was a butler once. He, I always remember him telling me the story where he had a piece of fish, and he got a bone stuck in his throat. He could barely breathe, and he literally had to put two fingers down his throat and pull the bit of bone out. And that's always frightens me, something like that. Oh, can you just imagine? I think the same thing happened to my nan, Nanny Hayes, years ago. She's not with us anymore, but I'm sure she too got a fishbone stuck in her throat. Oh, can you just imagine it? Oh, no. No, 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 no. Anyway, so I complained and sent that back. And back came later, I changed it for a burger and chips. So that arrived with a little bit of salad on the side. So I'm eating this burger. And then I turned over the lettuce leaf. Oh, my God, ants everywhere. Ants on my dinner plate. Oh, and I thought, oh, my, this is awful. Awful. And this was sort of a reasonably, you know, sort of classy place. First of all, bones in the fish. And secondly, ants all over the lettuce, dear. Ants in my pants. No, they were on the lettuce. Awful. Really awful. So I was really annoyed about that. And I went back to the, and I said, look, there's ants all over it. And so I said, oh, I'm ever so sorry. There must have been, this is someone I work for. Ever so sorry. There must have been ants in the bags of salad that they brought. Well, don't they bloody wash them first? You know. Don't you wash, do you just open the bags and chuck the salad onto the plate without even opening it? Oh, it's awful. Even when I buy it, I rarely buy bags of salad, but I generally wash them. You open the bag and wash them first because they've washed them in chlorine and stuff like that. You want to get all that off, don't you? Before they bag them up, and then you put them in a sieve thing and just wash them under the tap. Bit of a paper towel, dry the water off, and eat. They can't have been washing them first. Awful. So that was the worst meal I ever had. I've been out with some people who make the meal bad. So the food's okay, but there was a particular, I can't name them, no, I cannot name them. It was female. And whenever I took her out to dinner, all she would do was complain bitterly about something. She would start, oh, that knife's dirty. Oh, it's burnt. Look, send it back, it's burnt. And I stopped taking them out in the end. If someone takes you out for a meal, you know, you don't expect them to start complaining, do you? How bloody rude is that? All it did, every time it would moan, moan that there was something wrong with the meal. And I'd be sitting there quite happily eating it. I couldn't find nothing. It's almost as if they look for something to be wrong with it. And rather than, you see, I'm the sort of person, rather than see that there's something wrong with the meal, I feel it's my fault for bringing them out in the first place. Well, they didn't get taken out for any more meals, did they? And it happened on several occasions. So here's my question to you today. What do, have you ever had a bad meal out somewhere? And why? Or maybe you've had a really good one out somewhere, and why? My best meal out, leaving aside family, was with my best mate about 15 years ago at a restaurant in in Gran Canaria. I don't know why we sat there. I think we had steak and chips and MPs and something else. It was just a wonderful night. Something really nice about that particular meal. That was the best meal I ever had. Really was. What about yours? When was your best meal? Or maybe you've had got a bad meal experience? Then call in and let me know today. If you're watching the show live, you can indeed call in live. If it's Saturday the 22nd. Is it the 22nd today? Hang on a minute. If it's Saturday the 22nd of November 2014 and it's coming up to 19 minutes past 12 in the afternoon, then you are indeed with us live. And you can join in live by calling in on Skype. My Skype name is Chris Reardon, all one word, C-H-R-I-S-R-E-A-R-D-O-N. If you haven't got me on the Skype, add me, okay? Chris Reardon, all one word. C-H-R-I-S-R-E-A-R-D-O-N. Or there's a phone-in number, which used to come up on the screen, but for some reason isn't on the screen anymore. Do you want me to see if I can find that? I'm not sure I can, actually. Text, no, it's disappeared. So I can't put this thing. But the phone number is 020-8133-6358. All right? 020-8133-6358. If you're not with us live and you're watching or listening to a recording, you can still join in by email. I always read your email out in the short shows that I do throughout the week, or maybe next Saturday. And you can find that at chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Sometimes people put messages on the Facebook wall or on the YouTube wall, and quite often I do miss them from there, all right? So be warned about that when people start saying, oh, I sent you a message on the Facebook, but you haven't read it out yet. Well, I can't keep an eye on everything. That's the trouble. I cannot keep my eyes everywhere. Let's see. Hello to a couple of people who are with us this morning. Good morning to Kieran. Morning, Kieran, who is in Hertfordshire. It's a lovely part of the world. Kieran says, good afternoon, Chris. Restaurants always seem to take ages for you to pay. It's like they are asking you to walk out for you to... Hang on. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I know. Yeah, you got to call them over, Kieran. I know exactly what you mean. So you sit there, don't you? You've had your dinner and you've had your pudding and you're sitting there thinking, OK, well, I quite like the bill now. And you're looking around, aren't you? No one to be seen. They disappear, don't they? No, you're quite right, Kieran. And then he said, oh, can I have the bill, please? Oh, yeah, OK. And then it comes reasonably quickly. But, yes, I see exactly what you're saying there. Kieran says, my best meal out was at Gordon Ramsay's. Oh, really? Just beautiful. And the prices were OK. Now, which does he have various different restaurants? I think he's got various different... So where was the one that you went to, Kieran? How much was it and what did you have? That's what we want to know. Well, I've been to a Jamie Oliver's. Been to a Jamie Oliver's twice in Reading. But quite frankly, it was nicely presented and the staff were... Oh, I thought there was really pricey in there. Gordon Ramsay's. I haven't been to. But I forgot his name again now. Jamie Oliver's Italian in Reading we've been to a couple of times, and that's a bit pricey, so we won't be going back there. Too expensive. Thank you, Kieran. Let us know what you have. Good morning to Daniel, who says, hi Chris, some of the worst meals I have seen are on your cooking videos. Well, you won't be invited round for dinner then, mate. What a cheek. Cooking videos. Don't you like my cooking videos? Well, don't bloody watch them then, miserable git. Honestly, what's wrong with these people? He says, I don't think you could actually be sick just watching someone cook a meal. Vile people, vile people. Got to say good morning to Paul Edwards, who's with us this morning. And Paul has a rare Saturday afternoon. He's having a relaxing day today. So I get a rare opportunity to watch your show live. Oh, there must be something better for you to do. Come on, Paul. You can come up with something better than that, can't you, mate? Kieran says we had lunch. It was around £70 for two of us. Well, I think that's dear. Don't you think that's about what it was at Jamie Oliver's? 70 quid. What did you have for that? Was there a bottle of champagne involved? 70 quid for lunch? Jeez. You should go for pub lunches, Kieran. It's too much for dinner. Oh, 70 quid. Far, far too much for dinner. Anyone else? Come on, gang. Where have you had a really nice or a really bad experience of a meal? And what was the cause of it? Was it the food, the people that you're with, something like that? Do let us know. 020-8133-6358 or on the Skype. Skype username or one word, Chris Reardon. Look who's on the phone today. It's Daniel in Camberley. Good morning, Daniel in Camberley.
Hi, Chris. Can you hear me?
Just about. Were you on the Skype?
I am on Skype, yeah.
A very good morning to you, sir.
Good morning. How are you getting on with the new boiler?
Everything is it's too hot in here. I'm doing an experiment because if you're new to the show, let me just tell you, just had a new boiler installed on Monday and some new radiators downstairs where there will be no more clothes hung across those radiators because they were rusty. You must see that all the time, do you?
What's that, sorry?
You must see that all the time, rusty radiators where people have put their clothes on.
Yeah, do see that a lot.
Mm. And they're the only two that have gone rusty. The two that have put clothes across the top.
You keep breaking up, Chris. Can you hear me?
Yeah. If you're on Skype, we can't talk at the same time, that's why.
Oh, right.
Well, say something then.
So I thought you were going to say something. That's going all right, though, the heat.
Yeah, I'm doing an experiment at the moment. So this week, it's on a timer, right?
Yeah.
So it comes on and off at certain times. Next week, I'm going to just leave it on at the set temperature and see what the difference in gas use is.
I would do the latter, leave it on at a set temperature.
What, permanently?
Yeah, because if you let the house go freezing cold, it takes longer and it's more expensive to heat it up to a reasonable temperature.
Okay, well, I'm doing that experiment this week. So I've taken a note of my readings. So for 1 week, I've done the timer. Or I will do the timer until next Wednesday, I think it is. And then for the next week, I'll leave it on the same temperature and we'll see what uses the most gas. It's not an exact experiment because, of course, it might get colder or warmer outside. But it'll give you some sort of idea, won't it?
I leave mine on all the time, just lower, a little bit lower.
How hot is yours on?
I leave about 19 normally, but 19. I don't like it too hot. But the girls, my wife and daughters, don't like it cold.
Right.
I leave it at about 19.
I've got a little portable wireless thermostat now.
Yeah, yeah. But you want to keep that, you don't want to put that in the living room, you want to keep that in the hallway.
Right.
Because otherwise the living room will get to temperature and the rest of the house will be freezing.
Oh, okay. So I leave that in the hallway, do I?
Yeah, the room that's best left in a room that's not occupied.
I like to keep an eye on my numbers, though. I like all these little gadgets flashing numbers at me all over the house.
Well, yeah, but it's all about the money for you, isn't it, and the heating.
Well, it is. We can't afford to turn things on and off all the time. I'll have to eat more crisps. Here, look, I've got a lovely bag of crisps here today. The Walkers, cheese and onion. I was hungry after going swimming yesterday. So on the way home, I popped into the newsagent.
And, you look like you've put on a lot of weight, Chris.
I have put on a lot of weight, yeah. I have. Never mind, I was going to buy one of those grab-sized bags of crisps, but they didn't have any. So they had the two smaller packets, so I thought I'll have two of those. But the price of two of those, and then the large bags were only a pound each. So, you know, you're not going to buy the two small ones. They came to over a pound, or you could have one great big large one for a pound. But I haven't eaten all the whole packet. I did give my mate a quarter of the packet.
See, I've just eaten them all. That's the trouble with me.
Oh,
well, I opened them, I'll eat the lot.
Do you buy the big ones?
Yeah.
I mean, the really big ones.
No, not the really big ones.
They're like 120 grams. 120 grams of ecstasy in this packet for just a pound.
Have you tried the, what are they called? Kettle's crisps.
Kettle crisps. Oh, yeah. They're very thick, aren't they?
Yeah, nice crisps.
But they do. And in Aldi, they do a yellow... cheese and onion, it's a yellow packet, and they're quite thick, and they're like 79 pence, and that's a great big bag.
Yeah, I do love crisps as well.
They're my favourite.
Yeah, but no good for you, are they?
No, they're not. You had had any bad meals out at all?
Oh, loads. I eat curries, you see, and curries are really hit and miss.
Right.
You can have some really bad curries or really good curries.
I mean when you're out, not sort of the next day or a few hours later. You know, when you're in the restaurant?
Yeah.
What sort of bad experiences have you had there then?
You probably know about Blue Becker's.
Who?
Blue Becker's restaurants. There's one in, that's scattered around our area.
I'm sorry, Louis Becker?
No, Blue Becker's.
Blue Becker's.
Yeah, they're a restaurant chain that started by... a guy local. He's got one in Warfield, one in Odeon, all around these areas.
No, never heard of them.
Yeah, they were good restaurants, and then they sold out to a pub chain, and it all went downhill.
Right.
You know, steaks you couldn't eat.
Well, why couldn't you eat them?
Well, just so tough. It was unedible. So yeah, send them back. I always hate sending food back because they're not paranoid of what they're going to do.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's ruined. I'd never like to send it back. the chef's going to spit on it and send it back out to you again. You know,
a little old lady I used to know, Gwen. She's not here anymore. She used to come to my karaoke nights about. She left the planet. I think about 3 years ago now, and
left the planet.
Yeah, what gone to it? Heaven. Gone to heaven.
I thought you mentioned a bit of abducted.
I don't know. I think I'd quite like to be abducted by aliens and taken to another planet or something like that. As long as they don't dissect me.
Or experiment on that.
Yeah, I don't like the idea of being dissected, really. Certainly not while I'm alive.
No. That could be
Anyway, she used to come around with... And we was at a place in Islington called the Golden Lion where I was doing... Now, what was I doing there? I was doing a bingo night there. Bingo karaoke night. And she ordered this food, and it came. And she put down in front of her. And anyway, they went away. And she looked at me, and I looked at her. I said, you don't like the look of that? She said, no. I said, do you want to send it back? She said, oh, no. She said, never, ever send anything back if you're at a restaurant, because you don't know what's going to happen to it when it goes back in the restaurant. There was one place I took my aunt took me to when I went to visit her last time. Now, she lives in a place called Tring, which is very near Hemel Hempstead in Hertfordshire. And there, it's all open. There is no kitchen. The kitchen is in front of you, to the side of us. And everything is being done in front of you. They don't disappear into a kitchen. All the chefs are at the front cooking, and then it's like just like a counter.
What was it, a Pizza Express? Because all those were open kitchens.
No, I can't remember the name of it now. But it was intriguing and it was reasonable. I had this Arabella pasta. Pasta Arabella, something like that.
Nice.
Yeah, yeah, it was very spicy and tomato-y. I had that, and I think she had a chicken thing. Really nice. But you saw it all being cooked in front of you. I quite like that idea. Then, you know, you could send something back then and not worry about someone picking the nose and putting it in there.
You can't beat the old Toby Carvery though, can you?
Oh, I'm there all the time. We used to go there a lot more often than I do now. I was going at one point once or twice a week with my mate.
That's good value, isn't it?
£6.99, I think it is, or £5.99, something like that. Yeah. And you see, the trouble is, it's the potatoes, the roast potatoes. I don't know how they do them, but they're to die for.
Yeah. But what do you do, because you don't have the meat, what do you have, a vegetarian substitute?
Well, you can, and I did. I used to have a vegetarian substitute that would be like some sort of flan or something, which was always very nice. But I found, because I was putting so many potatoes on the plate, that takes a little bit longer to get the vegetarian, because I have to cook that special, right? So I found I'd be getting the vegetables, eating those, and by the time the other thing had arrived a few minutes later, it was too much. So I stopped ordering the extra bit.
So you just have the veg and the spice?
Yeah.
Some of the plates they pile up.
It's dreadful. Now,
I like my grub, but blimey.
Yeah, I don't mind if someone's going to pile the plate up and they finish it. But the thing is, Daniel, they don't. And that just really annoys me. They've come back with this plate and a mountain of food. I mean, I go back, I can't lie to you, I go back with a mountain of food. It's potatoes, carrots, peas. The Yorkshire puddings are really nice.
Yeah.
What else? A bit of stuffing, maybe. Something else there is I really like. The onions.
Yeah.
You know they do these red onions, don't they, in a great big vat of red. Oh, beautiful. And some gravy. And I will sit there and eat it all. There's not a thing left, not a pea, nothing. And then the same at home. Can't stand wasted food. And you get some people in there and they've piled the plate up, right? And then they leave. And half the food is still on the plate. That annoys me. That really annoys me, Daniel.
Yeah, they're walking back to the table, gravy sloshing over the sides.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, no, it is. I might have to go up there this afternoon now. Start. Yeah.
Are you going? Wait, is it a little bit dear on a Saturday or is that Sunday?
I think Sunday's dear, isn't it?
Sunday's, and it's not that, just a bit dear, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not. At the end of the day, if you anywhere you can eat for under a tenner, including a drink, I mean, you can't grumble at that.
No. I think some of them are open Christmas Day, but it's going to be like, I would guess, about 30 or 40 pounds a head on that particular day. I don't know if you wanted to do that.
I'll have to suffer one of my wife's Christmas dinner again.
Oh, I bet she's a good cook, isn't she?
Yeah, she's all right.
Huh?
Yeah, she's all right. It's just our witch of a mum that comes round as well.
All right. Oh, well. There's that to look forward to.
Yeah. Where are you going up to your relatives?
I'm likely to go up to my sisters, yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, I'll let you get on then, Chris.
All right, young Daniel. Thanks all for calling.
No problem, bye.
Cheerio now. There we are. Our good mate Daniel in Camberley. I was in Camberley this week, Daniel. I should have told you then. I was at... I met up with my little friend Mikey, who's now known as Mike, because he's older now. You see, he's older now. Went up with Mike, who's at a university there, and he, I think he helps teaching some of the children and what have you now who are in university. And we had a cup of tea in upstairs in Tesco's. I know all the best places. Tesco's upstairs there. It was a nice cup of tea, though. Kieran in Hearts says that Prezzo have open kitchens. I don't think I've ever been to a Prezzo. Why haven't I been to a Prezzo? I think it was the prices. The prices in Prezzo seem to be quite expensive. Yes. Anyone else got any experiences of restaurants, good or bad? Or maybe pub food, anything like that. Maybe it's as simple as going to, you know, one of the fast food restaurants and you had really bad trouble there. Let us know. Give us a call. 020-8133-6358 if you're in the UK. It's a local London number. 020-8133-6358. Or you can use a Skype username, all one word, Chris Reardon, ChrisReardon. You can call in on either of those two. Or indeed, you can send messages on Skype if you're not a member of like my little Skype thing, then just add friend or whatever and I'll accept that, and you can send messages over there. If you're watching a recording of the show, once again, join in by email chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. We have got to sing happy birthday to someone, boys and girls, and it's Marge's mum.
That's unfortunate.
Oh my god.
Isn't that unfortunate?
Well, you're not. Don't walk in like that. How can you just walk in like that? You terrified me then.
I was so annoyed.
Well, hang on a minute. I haven't got a microphone for you.
I tried to call a real TV and radio station and couldn't get through to them. So I thought,
look,
I know,
they can't see you. You're just a voice now. Look,
my friend is doing his hobby radio today. So I thought I'd come round and annoy him.
Frighten the life out of me then.
It's so annoying. So this morning, I get three letters from the same estate agent asking me if I want to sell my house. Three letters from the same... What a waste of paper, what a waste of resources, and what a...
Tell them to stop pestering you, dear.
So I rang them. I got through to a very nice girl. I said to her, why is it... I keep getting,
well, can you hang on a minute while I just...
You're more than one database. So they have an array of databases that everybody's on. What? I said, just blank it. I said, I want
to
follow them.
Don't want to be on. Don't want to be on there.
None of them. It's disgusting.
Don't
absolutely
want to be on.
Disgusting.
How rude.
It's a waste
it's the wrong one, dear.
A waste of...
1 minute.
...resources
can I
and a waste of paper... Minute. And a waste of everything. It's so bloody annoying. I'm furious.
I don't know if anyone heard any of that, dear.
Of course they did. I've got a loud enough voice. See,
look, tell us about that, love. 1 minute.
Yeah, so annoying. And then...
Why have you appeared early? Do you want me to go... Oh, you want me to go to Waitrose, don't you?
Of course, yeah.
Well, you'll have to wait till I've finished, dear.
That...
What's the time? Oh, it's a... Christ, look, 20
that,
minutes has gone already.
I know. It's,
well,
no,
hang on.
40
shut up a minute.
Gone already. 40... What? You've been whittling on for 40 minutes.
Shut up a minute. That's not working, is it?
Yes, it is.
No.
Doof. Doof. See?
Look. No, this is the one working. Look, if you tap it, nothing coming on that one. What have I done?
Well, who knows?
Hello. No, that's not working.
Oh, okay. Well,
I might be on the wrong plug. Hang on, there's so many bits and pieces here, dear.
Oh, well, it's not quite the BBC, is it?
Eh?
It's not quite
hang
the
on, where's
BBC.
That? Where's that plugged into?
I don't know.
Well, it should be working.
Oh, what's this?
They're not for you.
This is breakfast.
They're not for you. 1 minute.
Well, who are they for, then? Crisps on the floor. Oh.
No, it's not working, that microphone. I don't know why.
Carry on.
Plugged into the wrong one, dear.
I'll just sit here and say nothing.
Eh? Now, what's this? There's another wire here. Anything occurring?
No.
Hang on. No, nothing.
That's all right. I'll just sit here and say nothing.
Well, you can't just sit there like that, can you?
Mm-hmm.
No, I must have turned something off here.
Well, aren't you a DJ?
You're sitting there. No one can see you. Are you stupid?
I'm going to move over in a minute.
Oh, and it's hot in here, isn't it?
Mm.
Now, 1, 2, that's that down there. I don't think that's going to work. I don't know
has
why.
Has he been wittering on all morning? I didn't turn him on, to be honest.
Well, it used to work. That used to work. Oh, those. Don't eat my crisps.
Why?
Have you had breakfast?
No.
Oh, look, Terry H has appeared.
You're
good morning, Terry H.
You want me to staff, don't you?
Hello, Terry. There you are. Terry's writing us a little message. Now, we've got credit card news today, boys and girls. Oh, yes. There it is. One minute. Credit card. You've completely thrown me, you have, dear. Just turning up like the front of life out of me. Well, don't eat those in front of me. This sounds disgusting.
Oh, I'm so... 1 minute you're telling me to get in shot and then you're telling me to go away.
Well, they stink. Don't eat all my crisps. They're for later when I'm hungry because we've got to rush out to Waitrose.
Greedy Chris Reardon.
Huh? Not greedy. Now, where's my credit card thing? That's where we went last night, you see.
Oh, I knew you was going to do that.
The flowing spring. It was not the flowering, the flowing spring.
Yeah, same
see?
Thing.
Nice pictures. Do you know that gets flooded?
Well, obviously, because it's right by a river.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The entire car park gets flooded. Oh, that would have made me so happy to see your car floating away down a river.
It wouldn't,
somewhere.
Actually, because when I first
hilarious.
Got my car, we had the floods, if you remember, and Andy's hotel was surrounded by water.
Yes.
And the first day I had my car, I drove through, and the water was up to the windows. Through that water, no problem. That's what you that's what you get for having a four-wheel drive quattro Audi.
Do you want to go and brush your teeth? Oh, it's awful.
What, because of the cheese and onion? Yeah. That's what you're like when you eat them, dear.
If I have some, will that stop your smelling?
Yeah, it will, yeah. It will help.
Well, I shouldn't really. I'll have a couple.
Yeah, you should.
Oh.
What's it? I've had a bad experience at Subway yesterday. As they were making my sandwich, she put a small amount of salad on the sandwich. I said, can I have more salad, please? She said, that's the amount we put on. I said, you've hardly put any on. And she said, I'm sorry, I can't. So I said, well, I don't want it then, and walked out. Do they not understand we are paying customers?
Oh, we've had that before.
But, you know, Subway, that's Subway for you. A few.
Mm.
Do you want a shovel? Yeah, so, yeah, I mean, I'm not really a Subway type person. I like to get my sandwiches from Waitrose or Little Waitrose, or as we saw last night, Minute Waitrose.
We saw a really tiny Waitrose.
Don't talk with your mouth full. It's not nice. Close your mouth while you're eating, please. Tiny, minute. A bit like Chris's personality. But, what else? Someone else is Daniel's. Daniel's done a message there. Let's have a look at Daniel.
Are you able to work it?
What's Daniel saying? Is Andy Hotel the Runnymede by any chance? Yes, it is.
Oh, we don't know if we can give that information. He might turn up with his family. Look at him. Do you want that sort of person staying there?
He wouldn't be able to stay there anyway. Why, do you know Andy? Daniel? He'd probably look down his nose at you, to be honest. He's that type of person.
Oh, he is, actually. Awful.
He doesn't like tradesmen. He's not a tradesman type of person. And you look like a tradesman, let's be honest.
He is a tradesman. He does boilers and all that, doesn't he?
You look like a white van man with England flags hanging outside his house.
Who's that MP? That MP wouldn't like you. What's her name?
Stuck up woman.
That's awful. And Labour. She's Labour.
I know, but do you know, she's got a 2.9 million house in Islington, a £500,000 house in Farringdon, and another house somewhere else that she's just bought. It's disgusting. And these people are supposed to be, these Labour people are supposed to be for the working average man. Rubbish. They're all out for what they can get. I say vote UKIP. You met your wife there. Okay, was you staying there? I don't really believe that you was. Did you meet her in the car park?
It was fixing a radiator.
It was fixing a boiler. Look. So Terry H, why don't you eat the bag? Yeah, I don't know why he just doesn't put the whole bag in his mouth at once, because his mouth is big enough.
I love cheese and onion crisps. Is it me or is it really hot in here?
It's not that it's really hot, it's just you.
Grab that thing and turn that air conditioning on for a bit. I'm so hot in here today. I'm just underneath that other TV screen there. No, that's my asthma thing.
Asthma. Oh, I love it. I love it when he goes on about his asthma. Oh, my asthma's really bad today.
It's not funny. that sometimes. Rubbish. I've had coughs this morning. It stopped now. I had coughs early this morning.
So if you stay there many times, Daniel, do you go on the nights? Do you do that thing where you log onto the internet and get cheap rooms?
What's that?
You know where you log onto the internet and it's like Trivago, I think it's called.
Never heard of it.
Yeah, you get like a cheap room in a hotel.
That's what I was saying earlier. When I look for things like restaurants and deals, I can't find anything. I was telling them earlier about... Oh, is there a ghost in here? Oh, it's the air conditioning. Come on. Thank God for that. Because it is very hot in here now. See, that's ridiculous. I've heated the room up so much. Why don't we just open the window? Yeah, open the window.
No, air conditioning is much better. It's better. Oh, do you mind? How disgustingly awful. And he says that he shops in Waitrose. Audi.
I'm going to have to cut that out of the recording.
Audi customer.
We've got a birthday to sing to.
Have we?
Yes.
Harold. Harold.
And she's not here anymore. But Marge wants to sing happy birthday to her mother on Saturday.
Hang on, I'll get a Ouija board out.
She always loved Waylon Jennings kind of music. Have you ever heard of Waylon Jennings?
No, I've heard I've heard of the Wailing Wall.
Waylon Jennings. No, it's not the same thing, dear.
Lon. L-O-N.
Lon.
Jennings.
It's
at the top of the Google.
Oh, is it?
Country and Western.
Ah, yes. Yee-haw! Woo-woo! Yee-haw! I'd like to go to a country and Western
night.
He's
been there for the Xmas parties.
What Xmas parties? Well, we must sing happy birthday.
Well, go on.
Hang on a minute. It doesn't say her name. Marge, you haven't told me her name. Well, it'll have to be Marge's mum. Do you want to learn? Would you like to sing with me, dear?
No, I've not got dulcet tones, have I?
Okay, no, you haven't.
Right, you sing. I'll get out the picture.
Is it getting cold in here?
No, it's lovely.
Happy birthday to you.
To you.
Happy birthday to you.
To you.
Happy birthday, dear Marge's mum.
Marge's mum.
Happy birthday to you.
To you.
There you are, Marge. Yes, Waylon Jennings. Look, Wikipedia. Look, 1 minute.
Not everything that you read on the internet is true. Did you know
no,
that?
No, I know that. Was an American singer... Oh, he's not here anymore. An American singer, songwriter, musical actor, playing guitar at a... Oh, Buddy Holly staff. He'd been in movies. There's a picture of him. Do you recognise him? I've never seen him
before. Never seen him before in my life, do you?
What films has he been in?
No, he's not been in any films.
He was the balladeer for Dukes of Hazzard.
Oh. So he wrote the theme tune...
Is that what a balladeer is?
Yeah, it must be.
Oh, I don't know. So there we are. Happy birthday, Marge, darling. Okay. Now.
is Andy a chambermaid? How dare
you? Yeah, I think that's what he does. Andy is a chambermaid, dear.
How dare you?
He is a chambermaid. Paul, oh, isn't that nice? Paul Edwards says, happy birthday to Marge's mum as well. Thank you, Paul. That's kind of you. Terry H says, oh, he's talking about the crisps there, weren't you? Yes, we've eaten. I shall be finishing those crisps later and perhaps buying another bag. Are you having dinner here?
I may do, yes.
You don't like cottage pie?
No.
There's something else. There's something else other than cottage pie in there.
What, are we eating before or after we go out?
Oh, before. Do you think? Well, I'll just have the crisps then.
Yeah, have the crisps. Stuff your face when you get back.
Well, we can have something in Waitrose if you want.
Yeah.
And Daniel said, oh, he's been there for the Christmas parties. Well, it's funny you should say that, Daniel. I mentioned to Andy, you know, that if they wanted a DJ or a karaoke man to... Sorry? To come and do the karaoke parties, you know, perhaps they could call me.
Winged it.
And
in 25 years he has.
He didn't seem very interested.
No.
Strangely enough.
No, he wouldn't.
There's a scan running on there. I've got to stop that.
Oh...
Do you know how to do that?
No, not really.
Okay.
I just think he wants to lean across me, really.
Oh, shut up. Now, where's that gone?
Well, you've probably stopped it now.
We can't have scans running while I'm doing this, because it'll all go wrong.
That'd be hilarious.
Where's that gone? It's gone. Where is it now?
That would be hilarious.
Shut up.
Oh, that'd be so funny. But that's what makes the show funny. You need to be a bit funnier, a bit more current.
I am being very current. Here's some currentness now. Now, boys and girls, as you well know, I'm a very big Barry Manilow fan. And
excuse me while I fall asleep.
Just to let you know, he is coming here to... He is now here in... Where have you gone now? Come back into view. Come back into view. Just... All you've got to do is sit there and look at them. They like to be looked at.
But it's boring about Chris Reardon and Barry Manilow.
Just a quick little bit about Barry Manilow, because he is now here in the UK, boys and girls, and 4 million people want to hear about him.
No, four viewers. Four. I'm going to take a photo.
Well, that's funny. That's funny. It was eight before you got here.
Let's take a photo of that.
What? What are you doing?
I'm taking a photo to show them... That it's four viewers. Four viewers. Can you see that?
No, they can't see it.
Well, it's not 4 million. I'll tell you that now for nothing. 4 million, my backside.
Anyway, Wendy, huge Barry Manilow fan, same as myself, has sent me this very important email informing us the dates and times if you want to see when Barry is on the telly this week. So, and radio. So, starting tomorrow night... On the Paul O'Grady Show, 88 to 91 FM, Radio 2 from the BBC. Da, 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 da.
Paul O'Grady.
He is on at 6 o'clock with a show starting at 5. So he's on Paul O'Grady Radio tomorrow. And then, what's today?
Saturday.
On Sunday, tomorrow. And also on Sunday night on BBC One. He is on Strictly Come Dancing at 7:15.
Is he going to dance?
No, I don't know.
I don't know how he's going to dance, because he could just about move around, can't he?
They don't... Do they... They don't do interviews on that,
no,
do they?
No, he'll probably sing and just
stand
there.
He must be just singing then. I wonder
unless they put
sing.
Him on roller skates and just whiz him around.
I hope he does It's a Miracle. That's one of my favourites. It's a miracle. Ba, 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 ba. It's a miracle. And then he's on The One Show. Ba, 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 da, one.
One. Not exactly like high entertainment. Like.
Shut up a minute. The One Show on BBC One, Monday at 7 o'clock. Then he's on next Saturday, ITV One, on the Jonathan Ross Show at 10:30. Then Monday week, he's on Monday the 1st of December between 6 and 8:30am with Good Morning Britain. No one's watching that though, are they? No one watches that. Oh, Barry, you should have gone on. You should have gone on
Jeremy Kyle.
Should have gone on Breakfast Time, dear.
Should have gone on Jeremy Kyle.
You should be on Jeremy Kyle.
You should be on Jeremy Kyle with your family.
You should be on Jeremy Kyle.
Well, I shouldn't say that because three of the viewers are probably your sister.
Sorry?
Oh, we've got up to six views. Six people are now watching.
And this, and then it's on Thursday the 4th of December on This Morning. 10:30 to 12.
With Philip Schofield. And what's that other stupid
woman? Well, it's better than that crap you... What did you have on the other day? Loose Women.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
God.
But it's better than the rubbish you watch. Doctor Who, douche wash.
Doctor Who's finished now.
Good. Load of rubbish.
Doctor Who has now finished. Stop. So that's that. Now... You can do the messages.
What messages?
Little blue things flash up when people are sending messages there.
Never go to a supermarket hungry. You buy more.
Yeah, so
that very well may be the case, but I don't really want to eat yet because I need to go shopping. Thank you, Terry.
Well, you've had half the crisps anyway. No, You've had your lunch, haven't you?
So I might have a bowl of soup in. They've got a lovely cafe.
We'll have a cup of tea before we go, though, isn't
it? They have a very nice cafe in Waitrose.
Yes, they do have a cafe.
Yeah.
If we get the comfy seats. Sometimes there are old people sitting in the...
So Chris goes and sits next to them and starts talking to them and they soon get up and leave.
I do.
It's hilarious.
Or you know, he sits down and passes wind, and that soon gets
I don't ever do a thing like that. I've never passed wind in my life.
Oh, my God. And in the car yesterday.
How dare you? That
oh, it's awful.
You.
And you close... He does it and then closes the windows.
I don't
and because
think
he's the driver, I can't... I don't have control of the window. Dirty
I don't
git.
Think so.
Dirty
I don't
bastard.
Who's Kieran? Kieran.
That's Kieran?
Kieran.
What does your best friend do for a living?
I do lots of things. I'm a people person. What do I do? I make people happy. I make people smile.
Well,
Daniel
doesn't seem to be working for me.
Bloody Barry Manilow news again. I know. When is he going to leave the planet? I think
but
he's
actually,
already dead, but he's just
he's
got batteries.
Say those things about Barry.
And no, I wouldn't eat his food. It's normally out of a box.
What food?
Well, it says I can't believe Ronnie would eat your food.
My food is not always out of a box. What about that chilli I made?
You told me that was out of a box.
It was not out of a box. I made a chilli.
Oh, I must go and have it
when
all
did I make
out.
It? Thursday
oh,
I made
God,
chilli.
Oh, God, it's out of date as well. I'll be dead tomorrow.
I put three chillies in it.
I'll be dead tomorrow.
They were nice. The rest is in the freezer now.
I'll be dead tomorrow. Out of date. Giving me out of date food.
Anyway, if I may get a word in edgeways, as it is my show, you know, with Chris Reardon.
Yeah, but it's not quite the... It's not... Well, it's far from the BBC.
I never said it was the BBC.
Oh, the way you go on. Do
what
that thing.
What do you mean the way
do
I go
do that thing.
What thing?
Do it so I can ridicule
what
you.
What thing?
Do that thing. You know what I'm talking
what
about.
What thing?
Do it.
I don't know what you mean.
You know, because I saw the eyes move to the left, so you know what I'm talking about.
No, I can't think.
He does this silly thing, and I ridicule him every time. Because he thinks that
silly
this is some big,
so.
Massive studio.
It is a big, massive... It's KWT London, darling.
There's no such thing as KWT.
It is KWT, part of United Kingdom Talk.
There is no such thing as KWT. It's a cat. It's a cat called Katie. And you can touch
Katie
one wall...
Worldwide Television.
You can touch one wall to the other wall, because it's so small in here. And the camera's on a videotape that is cable-tied to a bracket on the wall for
right.
a shelf.
Have you ever been to a TV studio?
Yes, I have, many
right.
times.
Have you looked around at actually how everything is held up with bits of string and tape?
Yeah, no, BBC's
but you
not.
Don't see it on the
when
t-
you
yes,
pan,
it is.
When you pa- when
yes.
pan across...
Yeah, that's the bit you can see.
Nothing.
You look behind those bits of wood, it's all bits and pieces,
no,
dear. It is. Because
no.
I've
no,
been
no, no.
several times.
Very funny chaps. Great double act.
Won't be double for much longer.
Double.
I didn't know.
He's
I didn't
double
know
by himself.
I didn't
He's
know he was coming up
himself.
The stairs today. No preparation. No extra
double
mic ready.
Double by himself.
Very unprofessional, dear. Sorry.
Did Ronnie say he pleasures people for a living? No, I don't pleasure people for a living. That's very rude.
He's a rude person. He is.
Yeah, he's very rude. I don't think I'm going to answer any more of your questions,
no.
Daniel.
Hang on. What's he doing? Oh, he's minimised you. He's
yeah,
minimised.
Minimised.
So that's the Barry Manilow news. And you were saying, why doesn't he disappear off the planet? Actually, Daniel, he's doing his last tour next year. Now, he's already got loads of US dates. Don't know if he's coming to the UK or not.
Can I say something about
that? Well, wait a minute. I hope he is. I hope he is, because I'm kind of waiting for the UK shows, right? But there's a chance he won't be, in which case I'll miss out. That's why I haven't booked to go to America. Plus, I'm a bit lacking in the old spondoolies at the moment.
Poor.
Not many shekels are in the account.
He's poor.
Since I've had to pay a deposit for a car, a new fridge, which arrived. That was exciting. A new fridge arrived yesterday. Zanussi fridge.
It's John Lewis, isn't it?
No, it's a Zanussi one. And
what's exciting about a fridge arriving?
It's a new thing, isn't it? A new gadget in the house.
Did you see the men?
Very nice. Two men, as usual, the old John Lewis service. Come in, take the old one away for £9.
They left their gloves.
Oh, he's left his gloves. Should you think I should ring him? I've got his number on there.
Yeah, you should do, yeah. You should ring him and say to him, excuse me, you left your dirty gloves in my nice clean house.
Yeah. They come away, take all the rubbish away, set it out. But you can't turn it on for 4 hours because everything has to settle, doesn't it?
Yeah, the gases. It's a bit like you. It's a bit like you after you've been
perhaps
on a plane.
Perhaps if I just put you in the corner for a while, your gases would settle and stop leaving your body. Kieran wants to say something. Is he an IT boy?
No, I'm an IT boy.
No, he can't do computers.
No, I'm an IT boy. I am an IT boy.
Cannot do computers.
Oh, I can. I'd use Mac. I use Mac. Much more superior than this rubbish that you use.
Well, I would consider getting a Mac just to do the shows, but I don't know if my little that thing would work on it because...
You're little. There's nothing little about you, love.
Sorry? I don't think that would work on it, which is how I change the pictures and things around. So
I'm sure Mac would do a better one. Mac is
I could have a look on your computer for that, couldn't I?
If
it worked on yours, I know.
You mean my MacBook Pro?
Yes, I know that if I did it live show on that, I'm sure it would be better.
Of course it would.
But this isn't too bad. Terry, what's the picture like today? Are we in high definition and not sort of, what's the word when it's
blurry?
No, when it goes like da-da-da,
buffering,
like, kind of stutters,
buffering
like that, buffering.
Smile. And stop. Anyway, yeah, so now the other thing I wanted to talk about was eBay.
Well, look at the time.
I've got a couple of minutes, thank you. Was eBay. So I ordered a jumper from eBay from America, and it only got stopped at customs. So I paid the fee, as you do, you pay the fee, and it came this morning, and it's not what it says it is.
Oh,
it's tiny.
No.
It's like a child's medium.
Well,
I'm fuming.
Are you going to sort that one out?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I could open a case and it'd be a big kerfuffle.
Yeah,
or...
but then say you sent that back to America.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Well, you've now paid the customs fee.
Yeah.
So how do you get that back?
Well, I wouldn't. So I might. I mean, I could probably sell it over here because it is quite an expensive item over here.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it a woolen one?
Yeah.
Is it woolen?
Woolen.
Okay.
Bah. Evil things.
All right,
evil
one more
things.
Message from Daniel and then we'll go. No, I don't think so.
No.
We don't think so. He's far too old to be doing that sort of job.
I'm not.
Well, we didn't get through all the things that I wanted to get through today, but that doesn't matter because I hope we have entertained you for a little hour, boys and girls, a whole hour of fun, fun, fun.
You normally go on and on and on, though. Why do you stop it at 1 o'clock when I'm here?
No, I don't go on. I always stop at one now. That's it. Because people get bored after an hour. Look, it's already dropped one. Look.
People get bored after the first 5 minutes.
They
love.
Get bored after 1 hour and that's it.
5 minutes.
Five now. Thank you very much, boys and girls. It's been great fun today. Now, don't forget, we don't do a little show on Mondays anymore. So little videos Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, and you can find those by going to unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk, unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Do send in an email, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. There we are. We're going now to have a cup of tea and then to Waitrose. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Thanks for watching.
It's goodbye from him.
And goodbye from me. Goodbye.